Well, it's the middle of March here in Poway, California, and while it's a little cool to be planting moringa just in the ground outside, uncovered, we are going to be planting moringa seeds today in this raised bed. This raised bed is 16 feet long, it's 4 feet wide, and we are going to be doing an intensive cultivation of moringa in this bed for leaf production. We're going to split this bed up into like four different sections. In the first section, we're going to be planting seeds on a 4-inch by 4-inch grid, giving us a total of 120 seeds. In the second section, we're going to be planting on a 5-inch by 5-inch grid, giving us like 80 seeds. In the third section, we're going to plant on a 6-inch by 6-inch grid, giving us about 50 seeds. And then in our final section, we're going to be planting on a 7-inch grid, giving us about 35 seeds. In total, we're going to have nearly 300 plants in this raised bed. Not only are we going to be doing four different planting densities to see leaf yield, but we're also going to be planting seeds which are dry, just from the package. It'll be our control group. And then we're going to be planting seeds which have been hydroprimed. Hydroprimed is just a fancy word. It's a technical term, meaning that the seeds have been soaked for a while in water and then dried before planting. In our case, we've hydroprimed the seeds by soaking them for about 10 hours and then drying them briefly before planting. If you'd like to know more about hydropriming, please see my other video on that. I'll describe some of the latest research that's been done in that area and show you which technique might work best for you. So as we follow this, I'm going to be recording germination rates for all seeds. We're going to be looking at the stem heights over time, the stem diameters over time, as well as the leaf yield. And this should serve as a test bed just to get an idea of what the climate here in Southern California can support for an intensive cultivation of moringa. So I've gone ahead and put in this downspray irrigation system. Certainly a drip line could have worked, and I will put a drip line in later. That's the way this header was originally set up. But I went ahead and I put plugs where the drip line was going to go. And I put in this half-inch line now hooked up to these 20 sprayers. And I thought with such a high-density planting that it would be good to go ahead and to be able to just spray the whole area, at least until the little seedlings are 5 or 6 inches tall or so. And then I'll go ahead and I'll just lay the drip line in. So this first bed is planted, 36 holes, had a measuring tape. They're very accurately, precisely planted. I want this to be as high quality of a test as possible. And I'm going to go ahead and now do the other three spaces and lay out the holes. So we're down to the tight spacing here, which is 4-inch by 4-inch. Really tight spacing. So the intensive planting has been completed on this raised bed. I'm going to be monitoring soil temperatures. Have a probe in the ground. Right now the soil temperature at about 4:30 in the afternoon is 85 degrees. I will be putting row covers on this each evening, at least for the next several weeks, to keep the temperatures in the bed higher.
Thanks for watching, and be sure to check out the website, healthyleaf.com, for more information about moringa and the results from this project.